first time riding a motorbike. Grab is like the equivalent of Lyft here, and it cost me maybe 50 cents US to get a ride just about anywhere I wanted to go. You need a Vietnamese SIM phone number to use it, so just make sure that you get one of those. You can see how crazy the streets are here. I definitely didn't want to learn to ride a bike here. I wanted to check out the temples and stuff, and when I showed up, there were hundreds of school kids just getting out. I wasn't even sure if I was allowed to go into the temple at first. I hoo-hooped a bit waiting for them to be off, and I lost their collective shits. I wasn't originally planning on heading to the War Museum, but in the end I did, and I was glad I did. There's a lot from the Vietnamese perspective of the Vietnam War that they just don't teach in the US. It really drives home the problem with putting ideologies before human life. Here's a guillotine that's been used to execute people. And here are cages that they used to leave people in as a form of torture. All over the world, people were crying for this war to end. It took far too long, but thank God it did, because Vietnam is thriving without war for one of the first times in their history. They just won a minor soccer game and people are going insane in the streets. Tower of some company, and it's insane that no matter what direction you look, the city just doesn't stop. The rest is just me taking a bit of a train out of Saigon over to Mui Ne. Be sure to like, comment, and if you want to support me on my travels, donate $1 or more on Patreon. Thanks.
Thank you.